Greetings of the day. In this video lecture of business finance for 6th semester, we will start with the numerical of the portion of second unit, that is for capital budgeting. Before moving to the first method, that is payback method for numerical of capital budgeting, we will in short discuss the different methods of capital budgeting. So, methods of capital budgeting. This is the main title of our portion for unit number 2. And what we have to discuss is different method. First one would be payback period. It is also known as PBP. In short, PBP. Second one would be accounting, also known as average rate of return. Abbreviation is ARR. ARR. Next one is NPV, that is net present value, also known as LPV. This is the another method for determining the capital budgeting technique. Then next, last one is the profitability index, that is PI. It is the next method for evaluation of capital budgeting technique. Then another method is there, I would add it here, that is internal rate of return, that is IRR. These are the five important, there are other methods also, but these five are the one of the most important method in capital budgeting. First one is payback period, one of the simplest method for calculation, very simple method, short questions and all these things can be easily asked on that. Formula based, again accounting rate of return, it is also a simple method, formula based method. In payback period, we calculate the payback period in which the particular project or machine is going to give us the return. Whereas in accounting, our average rate of return method, that is ARR, we used to find out the return by on the basis of formula. Then is the net present value, that is NPV. It means that it uses the discounted cash flows for that purpose. We will discuss about NPV when we are going to start about the NPV. Then is the internal rate of return, that is IRR method. That is, we here use the internal rate as a parameter for taking capital budgeting decision. Next is the profitability index method, that is PI. Here again, formula based method, technique is used for the purpose of capital budgeting decision. But we will start with our first method, that is payback period. In payback period, we have to select project which has less payback period. Select project / machine having less payback period. Remember one thing, we have to select the payback period of those machine or those project which has been less. If suppose a machine is having a more payback period, then we would reject and select the alternate machine. And for all these 4 to 5 methods, we have to perform the numericals and form the solutions for it. We will start in today's lecture with our first method, that is payback period method. Kindly click on the link with the video for the purpose of viewing the question. If you want to see, the link of the question is attached with the video. So kindly refer to it for the purpose of the question, and here on the board I will form solution which would be of that question which you would see in this video. So kindly click on the link for the purpose of getting to the question. What the question says is, I would discuss you in the short. Question says that we have three projects X, Y and Z, and its cash flow at the end of the year has been provided for 5 consecutive years. Apart from that, we have been provided with certain amount of initial investment which is required for that project. With this, scrap value is provided for project Y and project Z, not for project X. And we are required to calculate payback period and consider or tell which project is better from the point of view of payback period. So we would solve the question in 3 phases. First one for X, second one for Y and third one for Z. Starting for the project X, write down heading, calculation of payback period for project X, for project X, first column would be for year, second column would be for cash flows, and third column would be for cumulative cash flows. We all are very well known to the word cumulative. It means we have to make total of all the years cash flow. First one for year, second one is for cash flows, definitely it is provided in rupees, and third one is for cumulative cash flows. Cumulative cash flows. Remember one thing, in question what we have been provided, that amount is given in 000 terms. It means that the amount has been reduced, so we have to write here ₹1,230. As it is been written in the question, same thing we have written into the what we can say solution with regard to the answer. So what we have been said, that at the first year, we have at the starting of the year, that is zero, we have made an investment for purchasing the project or for initiating the project, which amounted to ₹600. It is cash outflow. Remember one thing, what it is? It is, what is this 600? Cash outflow. That is why as the cash is gone from the business, I have written it in minus by taking the bracket. And what the other things has been said, in the next 5 years, we have been receiving the benefit, we are receiving the cash from this project. It amounted to ₹2,150,000, then again 2 lakh, again 1,50,000, and lastly 1 lakh. These are our cash inflows, whereas what we can say 600 was our cash outflow. So we have written it in this parameter. 600 was our cash inflow. Okay, so I would just rub it. I have shown it to you for just demotion. We don't have to write this kind of thing. It is for understanding for ours. That is why we have written it. I would write here cash outflow. As it was cash outflow, it was shown in the bracket as negative, and this is cash inflow. This is for just our working, not for working to shown into the question or solution. In examination, we don't have to show this kind of working. Though examination is going to be, or in MCQ pattern, though we need to understand all these kind of terms. So when we go to cumulative cash inflows, what we have to do, we have to make total of it. First outflow was 600, then we have an inflow of 200, 600 plus 2, minus 600 plus 200, minus 400, 400 minus 150, that is 250, minus 200, minus 50, then here we have minus 50, 150, matlab, it means that we are having positive cash inflow of 100 in the 4th year, and in the 5th year, it amounted to rupees 200. So, what we can say, payback period is after 3rd year, but before 4th year. After 3rd year, but before 4th year. So, it would be where? It would be somewhere here, in between. So, we have to calculate it. Therefore, write down. Payback period is equals to three years. Why we have taken 3 years? Because it is after 3 years we have least negative cash outflow in third year, whereas fourth mein kya tha ki positive aa gaya tha, isliye hum logon ne 3 years plus 3 years plus there are 12 months in an year, that is why we have taken the 12 multiplied by what was the amount of negative cash inflow lastly 50, and whereas next cash inflow amounted to rupees 150. यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा ध्यान देंगे, हम लोगों ने 3 years क्यों लिया, क्योंकि last negative cash inflow कौन से साल का था, तीसरे साल का था, इसलिए third year ले लिया. After that what we have seen कि we have came on to the opinion that it is between 3 year or 4 year, that is why we are using this formula. So 3 years plus 3 year में और कितना दिन जोड़ना है वो लिखना है. So in an year there are 12 months, that is why we have taken 12 months. It is similar due to the space constraint. I am writing it into the very small writing, but try to understand that was 12 months. Then from where we have get to our get to 50 year, we have used this one to reach to the 50. After that, from where we are, from 150, we are having 150 from here. Remember one thing, how we have taken it, what we have to do for the purpose of calculation, on the numerator side we have to take negative, last negative cash inflow, whereas in denominator we have to take last or next positive cash inflow, not cumulative, only cash inflow, whereas when we talk about numerator we have to take negative cumulative cash inflow. Okay, now we will simplify it. It would be 3 years, rather than writing plus you can also write and, 3 years and 12 divided by 3 equals to 3 years and 4 months, 3 years and 4 months. Quite simple. First of all, prepare the table of 3 columns. First one would be here, second one would be for cash inflows, third one would be for cumulative cash flows. It would be inflow and outflow, that is why we have written the word flow. For 0 year or at the starting point of the year, we have cash outflow, we would write 600 as our outflow, and same would be taken into the cumulative, negative 600. Then 1 to 5 year, we have written all our cash inflows, and similarly we have simplified. Minus 600 plus 200, what we have to do? We have to add it, I would write it for you. This plus this equals to this. Again, this plus this equals to this. In this pattern, zigzag pattern, we have to continue. This plus this equals to this, this plus this, minus 400 plus 150, 250, minus 250 plus 200, minus 50, minus 50 plus 150, 100, 100 plus 100, 200. But what we came to know, that our cash inflows, our payback period is somewhere between 3rd year and 4th year, that is why we have used the formula payback period is equals to 3rd year, which is last negative cumulative cash inflow, and 12 months which are in year, into last negative cumulative cash inflow 50 divided by next cash inflow 150. This is what we have taken, and after deducting it we came to opinion that our total payback period is 3 years and 4 months. This is for project X. Now we will move to the next project, that is project Y. So kindly refer to the link for the purpose of reaching to the question what the project Y says. The project Y says again similar kind of thing, but there is an addition. Addition of what? That it has again what we can say, scrap value, which is again a part of income for the business, which we have to take as a cash inflow for the business. So we would take it in that sense. So let's start with project Y. Write down heading: calculation of payback period for project Y. So what the question says that project Y has an cash inflow of initial investment of 450, that is 450,000. We would take it on the term of zero, that is negative 450, because it was an cash outflow, and similarly it would be transferred to cumulative cash flows. Then what we would do, we would write down all the cash inflows for 5 years. That was 1,50,000, then 2,60,000, 2,00,000, lastly 1,50,000. These are our cash inflows. Now we have to make cumulation. How we have to make 450, what we have to do? I would write it with black. 450 plus minus, that was minus 450. This is minus, that is why it is denoted by bracket sign. Minus minus 450 plus 100, what it would equals to? It would be equals to minus 350 plus 150, it would be minus 200 plus 260. Here we have a positive cash flow of 60, that is 60,000. Then plus 60 plus 200, 260,000. 260,000 plus 150, that is 410,000. So this is our cash inflow for project Y. Again we have used the same technique for calculation of payback period. Again what we have found, that our cash inflow is after 3rd year but before 4th year. It is somewhere between 3rd and 4th year. Again we have to calculate it in the same way. Sorry beta, I have mistaken here. It is after 2nd year and before 3rd year. I have seen the things. So it is after 2nd year but before 3rd year. It is somewhere between 2nd and 3rd year. That is why we have to find out where it is. So again we would use the same formula for calculation of payback period. Write down payback period is equals to, so what we have done in the previous segment of project X, we have said ki what the last our year was 200, second year, where we have last negative cash inflow, that was second year. So write down second year and number of years is months in a year, 12 month into last negative cash inflow of 200, next cash inflow of 260,000. So we would reduce it or we would simplify it. Second year and 12 month, 12M, that is month, I would write it here, 12 months into 200, that was last negative cash inflow, divided by 260, divided by 260. Now we would need to simplify it. How we can simplify it? We can divide it. 20 tens are 20, 13s are, so it would be 120 divided by 13, therefore 2 years, and 9.2 months. So we can definitely write 2 years and 9 months. 9.2 months is there, or 2-3 months would be there. So we can definitely write it as 2 years 9 months. That would be the payback period for second project, that is project Y. How we have taken 200, so we would also denote in this segment also here. The 200 was taken from here, whereas 260 was taken from here. What we have to do? We have to simplify it. That is, this is for project Y. Write down here total cash inflows plus initial investment. Accumulation is to be there. Again, what we have said? We have said after second year there is our payback period, but before third year. So we have applied the formula 2 years plus 12 into 200 divided by 260. The answer is 2 years 9 months. It means that if we have to compare between project X and project Y, I would definitely say that we should choose project Y because it has less payback period. Less payback period. So I would write it here for our reference. Project X payback period, project Y payback period, and last one is project Z payback period. So for project X we have calculated the payback period of 3 years and 4 months. For project Y it is 2 years and 9 months. For project Y we are yet to calculate. So write down heading calculation of payback period for project Y. Again we can form the table with three columns, that is year, cash inflows in bracket rupees in thousands, then cumulative cash flows again rupees in thousands. So what the question says, our initial investment is for rupees 5 lakh. Take the amount of 5 lakh in bracket because it is cash outflow, hence denoted in negative by showing bracket. Then for first year our cash inflow is 1,50,000. So what we have to do? Minus 500 plus 150, the answer is minus 350. Then for second year our cash inflow, negative cash in, our cash inflow is 150. Minus 350 plus 150, minus 350 plus 150. This is what we have done. So we get answer minus 200, or else minus 200. This is how we have to write it in financial terms. We should write into the bracket for showing the minus, then minus 50 again. The cash inflow is fixed. That is why we can easily solve it. Then it is 2,50,000 at the end of the fifth year. So again what we can see, the cash inflow is somewhere between the third and fourth year. Why between third and fourth year? It is after third because this is the last negative thing, and but before fourth year, somewhere between third and fourth year. So we have to calculate it by using our formula, that is payback period is equals to, so which is the after period, that is 3 years and 12 months multiplied by last negative 50 डिवाइडेड बाय नेक्स्ट कैश इनफ्लो 150 अगेन थ्री इयर्स एंड फोर मंथ्स. सो द कैश इनफ्लो फॉर फर्स्ट एंड थर्ड प्रोजेक्ट दैट इज प्रोजेक्ट एक्स एंड प्रोजेक्ट वाई इज सिमिलर दैट इज थ्री इयर्स एंड फोर मंथ्स वेयर एज पे बैक पीरियड फॉर प्रोजेक्ट वाई इज टू इयर्स एंड नाइन मंथ्स. हेंस वी शुड सिलेक्ट प्रोजेक्ट वाई. प्रोजेक्ट वाई वुड बी सिलेक्टेड बिकॉज इट हैज लेस पे बैक पीरियड. इट हैज लेस पे बैक पीरियड. दिस इज वॉट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड. वी हैव टू सिलेक्ट द प्रोजेक्ट विच हैज लेस पे बैक पीरियड एंड हियर वी कैन क्लियरली सी दैट प्रोजेक्ट X has 3 years 4 months and whereas project Y has 3 years 4 months. Project X has 3 years 4 months and project Z has 3 years 4 months. But project Y has less period, that is 2 years and 9 months. So project Y is been selected by the company. This is it for this lecture. In the next lecture, we will see the next technique of capital budgeting. Until then, stay tuned. Thank you.